Welcome to Properties of Exponents, Part 1. So what we're going to find is that solving equations that are more complicated depends upon our knowledge of the properties of exponents. So let's say, for example, that we wanted to multiply. Let's say we wanted to multiply x squared by x to the third. Okay, so if we think about this and think about what exponential expressions mean, well, x squared means x multiplied by x. And now we still have times or multiplication between the two expressions. And x to the third, of course, is x times x times x. So x to the third is x times x times x. And now what's important to notice is that at this stage, it's all multiplication. Now, not only is it multiplication here from the x squared and here from the x cubed, it's also multiplication between the two expressions, okay? So at this stage, we're noticing that it's all multiplication. And the reason that's important is because, well, at this stage, I now have x multiplied by itself completely 5 times. And we see the simplification, right? We see that x squared multiplied by x cubed is x to the fifth. Do you see what we did with the exponents, the 2 and the 3? Well, isn't 5 2 plus 3? So when you multiply two exponential expressions that have the same base, in this case x, you add the exponents. So we're going to create a little collection of properties for the exponents. And let's go ahead and write those over here. So over here we'll write our properties of exponents. Properties of exponents. And we just met the first property. So let's go ahead and write that down. The first property was that if you have a raised to the m and you multiply it by a raised to the n, well, because they have the same base and it's multiplication, you keep the common base, a, and you add the exponents. So it's going to be m plus n. Okay? And that's our first property. So notice that it's very important to have multiplication right here. So if you had another example for, where you were asked to not multiply but to add, let's say, and let's say you had, again, x squared, but now you took x squared and you wanted to add it to x to the third, well, what would happen here? We know that x squared is x times x, okay? And then you have plus between the two. And x to the third, of course, is x times x times x. Now, do you have x multiplied by itself 5 times? You don't, right? It's addition here, and that addition throws things off. And what that means is that you can't write this as x to the fifth. So what would you do in this case? Well, whenever you add or subtract polynomials, or terms, I should say, you have to do so, or you do so if they are what we call like terms, if you recall. And these terms are not like terms, and so we just leave them as they are. X squared plus x to the third. There's no more simplification that can be done in this case. And so the point of this example is that the properties of exponents are very particular. Not only do you need the same base, in this case, it's got to be multiplication there. And if it's not multiplication, you can't use that property. Okay, let's see another property, or we'll do another example and that'll give us another property. So let's say that you were asked to, how about divide? And let's say that you had x to the fifth divided by, how about x to the second? And if you write this out, well, x to the fifth is x times x times x times x times x. And x to the second is x times x. Now remember, you can cancel factors when you have multiplication. So I can cancel one factor of x in the numerator with one factor of x in the denominator, and I can cancel once more, right? Cancel, cancel, and I'm left with a 1 in the denominator. And what am I left with in the numerator? Well, I still have x times x times x, which is x to the third. So this is equal to x to the third. Now, if you had to guess what the property says, and you were looking at x to the fifth divided by x squared, do you see how you're going to get x to the third? What would you do with the exponents? That's right, you would subtract. So 5 take away 2 is how we got the exponent of a 3. So whenever you divide exponential expressions, and again they have the same base, you subtract the exponents. So let's go ahead and write that over here as our second property. So our second property is going to be this, that if you have, let's say, a to the m divided by a to the n, okay? Well, same base, and it's subtraction of the exponents. So it's a to the m take away n. So the first property was addition of the exponents, and the second property it's subtraction of the exponents. Okay, are there any other properties that we can illustrate through an example? There are. Let's try another one. Let's say that we were asked to simplify. And let's say that we had, how about x squared raised to the third power. Okay, so now remember, whenever you take something and you raise it to the third power, that means you multiply it by itself 3 times. So this means that you want to take x squared and multiply it by itself 3 times. So this is the same thing as x squared multiplied by x squared multiplied by x squared. But we said a moment ago that whenever you multiply expressions together and they have the same base, according to our first property, what do? Well, you add the exponents. So it's going to be 2 plus 2 plus 2, and I get x to the sixth. Now when I look at this, do you see how you can go from the original problem to this? What do with the exponents? Well, you multiply them together. So 2 times 3 is how you get 6. Now what that means is that whenever you have an exponential expression raised to another power, you multiply the exponents together. Let's write that down as our third property over here. So our third property is going to be this. A to the m raised to the n is equal to, well, you multiply the exponents, and I write that as mn. Mn means m multiplied by n. So people often confuse the first property with the third property. Now, in one case, we're adding the exponents, and in the other case, we're multiplying the exponents. So you add exponents when you have two expressions with the same base. You add the exponents. But over here, well, a only appeared once, right? The base a only appeared once, and then in that case, you multiply the exponents. So that'll help you remember when to add versus multiplying. Okay, so in the next video, we're gonna see a couple more properties of exponents, but why don't we go ahead and gain some experience using these three properties? Let's do a couple of examples now. All right, so let's say that we wanted to simplify. How about we have 3x squared multiplied by, how about y squared to the third power, all divided by xy to the fourth. Okay, so What I'm going to do is I'm going to simplify the numerator first, and then I'll worry about the denominator. So in the numerator, the first thing I'm going to do is this. I'm going to take that y squared and cube it. So the way we do that, according to my third property of exponents, is I multiply the exponents together. So I get 3x squared y to the sixth. And the denominator we're going to leave as xy to the fourth. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to use the second property that says that whenever you have division, you subtract the exponents. So do you see x squared and x to the first right here? I'm going to take the exponent of 2 and subtract a 1 right there. So the 3 remains the same, and I get x to the 2 take away 1, which is a 1. And now for the y, I get y to the, let's see, it's going to be a 6 take away 4, because it's division, right? 6 take away 4 is 2, so that's why I get a y squared. And so my answer is going to be 3xy squared. So you should note that to do this, what I was really thinking was this. I was really using division, right? X squared divided by x, and y to the 6th divided by y to the 4th. So even though I didn't write this, I was thinking this. 3 over 1 times x squared over x times y to the 6th over y to the 4th. So we don't write this. We don't write all of this, but I was certainly thinking it when I went from here to there. That is, the 3 over 1 is 3, 2 minus 1 is how I got x to the 1st, and 6 minus 4 is how I got y squared. Okay, so maybe taking another one like that. Let's say that we were asked to simplify. Okay, how about 6x to the second multiplied by x cubed squared all divided by, how about 9x to the seventh? Okay, so in this case, I'm going to simplify the numerator first, right? So the 6x squared, those remain the same. And this, x cubed squared, that's x to the sixth. I multiply the 3 and the 2 together. And then the denominator is remaining the same, 9x to the seventh. And now what I'll do is I'll go ahead and I'll multiply the x squared and x to the sixth. Now, how do you multiply these together? Don't you add the exponents? You do. That's property one, right? So whenever you multiply and they have the same base, you add the exponents. So it's not 9, it's going to be 6 still, x to the eighth, divided by 9x to the seventh. And now as far as the coefficients are concerned, the 6 and the 9 I can reduce, right? So 2 goes into 6 3 times. Whoop, sorry about that. Let's say 3 goes into 6 2 times, and 3 goes into 9 3 times, and now it's division here, right? X to the 8th divided by x to the 7th, and when it's division, you subtract the exponents. So it's 8 take away 7, which is 1, and I get x to the first, and that's just x. So my answer is going to be 2 over 3 multiplied by x. Okay, so in the next video, we'll introduce a couple more properties of exponents, and then we'll put them all together and do some more complicated examples.